Good day to everyone. Today we will see the behavior of the neutral wire and the current flow on it when three-phase line currents are not equal. This is also called as unbalanced load condition and will happen when single-phase loads are connected to three-phase lines without evenly distributing those. Now let's see how single-phase alternating voltage changes in a sinusoidal waveform. It is shown here spreading over two cycles. This voltage alternates very fast, between its maximum and minimum values continuously, with a speed of 50 cycles per second. In US, it is 60 cycles per second since frequency is 60 Hz in US. Although voltage value alternates here, we consider RMS voltage, that is root mean square value of voltage for electricity calculations. If you consider current flowing on this line, that too will vary according to the changing values on voltage, and the two curves advance with its sinusoidal waveform like this. On current waveform 2, we consider RMS value for all the calculations, and is marked here on graph as CRMS. Further you can see, both lines started here at the same time on zero value, and reach its maximum and minimum values, also on same time at same angle. This happens when three-phase load is with pure, resistive loads only. Since no inductive or capacitive load involved, voltage and current sine waves are in phase, and no difference in angle between them. This is the condition where the power factor value equals to 1, that is cos 0 degrees equals 1. But you know in most loads, especially with motors involved, there are capacitors and windings or coils present. In most cases, inductive load is prominent, compared to the capacitive load present. This will make some kind of inductive load to act perpendicular to the main resistive load. Result is, the current curve lags behind voltage, and will alternate with a shifted angle to the right, relative to the voltage curve. Here the power factor or cos phi value is normally around 0.8, and the shifted angle phi will be 37 degrees. There can be occasions where the resultant reactive impedance is capacitive, and the current curve will move with an angle to the left, relative to the voltage curve. Here too, the power factor is mentioned with a positive value, related to the angle shifted, but need to be mentioned as the condition where current leads voltage. You will see here how the three-phase voltages move with 120 degree angles between those. To mark unbalanced load on them, we will consider only the selected three cycles on three line voltages here. Let's mark three current waves also on the same graph with dotted lines. You will see that three current sine waves are with different heights, since current values flow on three phases are not equal here. Since we need to take RMS values for calculations, dotted straight lines are marked as RMS values here. Let's assume that blue, red, and yellow lines have RMS current values of 60, 50 and 40 amperes respectively, and are marked as A, B and C here. Current flowing on the neutral wire on this occasion can be obtained from the given equation. N equals square root of A squared plus B squared plus C squared minus A into B plus B into C plus C into A. Adding A, B and C squared values together makes 7,700. Adding A into B, B into C and C into A multiplications together becomes 7,400. Difference between those is 300. N is square root of 300, and the current in neutral wire here is 17.32 amperes. You can use this equation to check the current on neutral wire when a balanced load connected to the three-phase line too. Let's assume all three lines draw equal amount of amperes with the balanced load connected to it. Since A equals B equals C here, first part becomes 3 into A squared. Second part 2 becomes 3 into A squared. Since all values are same here. By deducting one from the other, two parts cancels out here and becomes zero, since both values are equal. You will realize now, the current flow on neutral wire is zero, when loads are balanced on a three-phase line. Hope you got fair idea now, on calculating the current flow on neutral wire, when loads are unbalanced on a three-phase line. If you think that this video is helpful, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.